DJ Scheme was just like, yo, send me beats for Juice WRLD. And I just like was sending him beats, like a pack or whatever, one by one. One day he was just like, yo, Juice got on one of them. And then, yeah, it was really that simple. I wasn't really working with anybody like Juice WRLD like before, you know, like with that type of vibe or style. You know, like a lot of my stuff, like early on was just like hard, like rap, crazy, like 808 loud, you know what I'm saying? Mosh pit type vibes. So that was really just like all new for me. Yeah, nah, the melody is definitely cool. And I got it from like a loop maker, a loop guy. Yeah, he just sent me like the melody and I just kind of chopped it up the way I felt like it should be, you know, and like formatted it or whatever. The bass is super simple and it's basically the same pattern throughout the whole entire beat. Then with the melody on top, it's like, so for me, like, I never really was into, like, music theory. So it wasn't like, you know, like, I knew the notes of the melody and then, like, I just knew where to put the 808. For me, it was more like I just kept it simple and just copied and pasted it, like, a bunch of times. And, yeah, it's the same pattern. It just worked, you know? I think sound selection is very important. However, like, when I made this beat, I wasn't really aware of, like, sound selection being such a thing, you know? Like, I didn't like go into it like, let me find the perfect sounds and like, you know? I just kind of went off of like what I felt, but I didn't like overthink each sound. Like, is this good? Is it, you know? Like, when I made this beat, I wasn't making a tight beat, you know? I was just like making something that was like in a melodic world. And then, you know, it just ended up being this. First thing I add to a beat is like the clap or like the snare. And then I do like hi-hats and then I do like 808. This is the hi-hat, and I basically just like put it on like a lower octave and I put effectrics on it. So this is the kick, and the kick was just like super simple. I put like an EQ on the kick as well. All right, so yeah, this is the clap right here. Just a simple clap. And then this is a perk right here. And then this is like a clap snare type of sound. Really, it's just like a feeling, like, cause like for me, like when I'm making beats or whatever, it's not like a math thing, you know? I'm not like adding things up, like, okay, like I have this much here, let me put this much there. I know for a fact, like it was just like a flow. It just felt good. Sometimes I like to just create and put it in the order that I want to put it in. And then at some point you gotta loop it eventually, you know? I really enjoy doing that and then listening to it afterwards, like bouncing it down, like not looking at the screen. And like just listening to it, you know? So the melody is like the same for like 16 bars. And then I switch it up after the 16 bars. And this is when a verse comes in. What I normally like to do is I like to get creative with it. So like, they could, like, someone can send me a loop some way, but like, I like to get in there and like, you know, arrange it, rearrange it, stuff like that. So for whatever reason, I just felt like putting that part there, you know, I just wanted it to change there. It was more or less just like a feeling, and like, I do what I feel, you know? Yeah, for me, like whenever the artist sends back the final song, it just always shows me like, wow, like this beat has always been good enough for someone to get on it, you know? And it's like, sometimes you make a beat and you think that it's not enough. You might think it's too simple, but the more simple, the better to me, you know? Because it leaves like room for the artist, and then it's like the lyrics over the beat, it's a whole nother instrument, you know? It's like a filler.
Oh my God, Ronny.
My tag basically came from like a little house party. It was like a house party vibe, and it had like a studio set up in there. Like one of my homies basically told like some girl to like go up to the mic and say, oh my God, Ronny. And then she did it like a few times and I just like chose one and I was like, I'm gonna use it in a beat, you know? Once she did it, I was just like, yeah, that's probably, that could probably be one, you know? It just worked out for me and like my brand. But like, there's a lot of producers that are like super like rich that don't have tags, you know? So it's not all about a tag. Yeah, I would say my advice would be for a younger producer or like another producer to basically just like keep on producing as much as you can every day to get better, you know? It's all about just like staying consistent. Beyond that, it's also about relationships. So I would say like work on like building relationships and like people skills and like stuff like that, you know?
One of the biggest reasons that producers get placements is based off of like relationships, like now more than ever, you know? Because there's so many kids that make beats on YouTube that don't have any placements that are actually really good. You know, you can make beats all day, every day and pump out 1,000, but like, it's all about who you know. You know what I'm saying? It's not really just that, because there's also people that are trash, but they know the right person and they, you know, they land shit. So I feel like that's really what it's all about, you know? People like working with people that they actually like.
I've never met Juice WRLD. I wish I did though, man, for real. Like the way he be freestyling, I feel like we would've had a lot of fun. He has not a care in the world, no, I'm lying. Taking all these mans to the face, get me flying. Taking all these men to the